Mark Hancock this morning from CuFe Ltd. Mark, good morning.
Yeah, morning to you, Andrew. Nice to see you.
Yeah, good to have you back on, Mark. A significant resource update here you've announced for the Orlando deposit within the Tennant Creek Project. Tell us a bit more.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, we did some drilling last year. I guess drilling was primarily designed to get us some new core and enable us to progress some studies. But as part of that, we've also been able to grow the resource and equally importantly, I guess, to progress the categorization of some of the resource through from inferred to indicated. So we ended up with about a 16% growth in contained metal and moved about 25% of the material from inferred to indicated, which now means that over three quarters of that Orlando material is indicated. So as we move forward into mining studies and that sort of thing, that obviously gives us a higher level of certainty that we can rely on.
And this resource estimate here seen an increase of 16% in copper, has it?
That's right. Yeah, copper predominantly. So that's our key focus there. There is some gold credits available also within the material, but yeah, I guess our primary focus is thinking of it as a copper product with some gold credits available.
So at Tennant Creek, you've now got resources for three deposits, have you?
Yes, that's right. Yeah, so across the wider resource space there, we've got Orlando. The main reason we talk mostly about Orlando is it's an existing open pit, and so we think the ability to cut that back is a bit easier and quicker. But also at Gecko and Goanna, we have remaining resources there. They've been historically mined underground, so certainly possible to get back and reopen up the underground, but it's a little bit more comprehensive piece of work. So as I say, the first plan is to look at these concepts around the open pit cutback, which we think will give us the best chance of generating early cash flow. And that can then help us to move on to those other projects in due course.
And what about, tell us a bit more, what about the wider exploration potential at the project?
Yeah, we think there's still plenty of untapped potential in the area. Some of the deposits like the Monitor area, which is another area that had been drilled historically, had some interesting intercepts that have never really been fully followed up. I guess the previous owners had sort of moved on to other projects, and so we're definitely doing a bit of a regional review to work out where to follow up on that one and also look at other prospects in the area. We've seen a couple of other discoveries by a few other listed companies in the area over the last 6 or 12 months, and so certainly while it's an area that's been mined for many years, it's definitely got remaining potential for new exploration techniques and just following up on existing discoveries. So yeah, certainly that's going to keep us pretty busy over the next few months.
And Mark, just while I've got you, as far as the iron ore price, we're seeing a bit of positivity, so clearly some positive knock-ons here for the JWD project.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, it's generally been pretty solid. Still has a few ups and downs. I guess what we've seen over the last week or so in particular is the lump premium pushed up significantly. It had sort of been sitting down below 10 cents for the last few months, and it was back up at 16 cents on Friday. So for a project like JWD, which produces lump grade in the order of 63%, we get 63 times that 16 cents. That's a per unit price of Fe basically. So that's about $10 a ton extra that goes onto our price relative to most of the other mines which are producing fines product or perhaps even producing a lower grade lump product and don't get access to that full premium. So yeah, we're very encouraged to see that, and we'd like that trend to continue, obviously. Hopefully we see that push through over the next few months.
Good to speak, Mark. Thanks very much.
Yeah, pleasure. Thank you, Andrew.